What's up, guys?
Back once again. Once again. In the background is the Public Psyche, the vinyl Hypertension did. I showed the limited package, but not the actual record. This is the sleeve for the record. Slightly different artwork than the CD version. Yes, so that's in the background. If you like what you hear, support the band. And support us a little bit. What this is, as you can read up here, is another unboxing video. I would like to thank Danny GoToWarX for shouting out the last unboxing I did for his label, GDW. One of the comments was stop unboxing, or keep unboxing out of black metal, it's gay as fuck. So that was the comment on that share by the label. Now, I don't know what's more gay, promoting records or commenting like a little girl on Facebook. If you're so cult and deep and black metal and whatever, the fuck are you doing on Facebook? But that's enough for that. Everybody has got to have some haters, right? What we're doing today is a big ass unboxing from this cute-ass label. Signal Rex, or Signal Rex, is from Portugal, so depending on where you're from, you're pronouncing a difference. I call it Signal Rex, I'm not sure. But yeah, message. Big-ass box. This is an order, This is an order that started with, when they announced Endelok and the other one, the two Icelandic bands that he would do vinyl for. I started communicating with him, and this is just a running order that kept going until I think the last Black Gangrene update he did. That's coming apart, so everything before that is in here. And like you can see, there's some stuff in here probably that I don't remember. But that's got it. So that's fast, nicely packed, great mailers, love these mailers. So yeah, it is a pretty big box. One more cut and we're done. That's it. Right off the bat, there are three tapes in here. There is some sticker stuff. Of sticker stuff and some flyers I will try to show. There are some extras in here, I think. Let's see. There we go. So yeah, let's start from the top and work our way down to the bottom. Because there are some surprises in here. What's first? It's two Harvest of Death stickers, the sub tape label, not sub but the tape label, a Signal Rex sticker, then Black Hateful Metal flyer, absolutely disgusting, that's cool, and then the Passes of Life fanzine. I'm not sure what this is, but it has Kids Knox, yeah, Passes of Life too, not sure, a zine flyer. We're drinking Porto, Portugal. And it's not even weekend. Okay, onto the tapes first. These are packed especially well. Within the box, another layer of bottle plastic. And let's see, yes, this is the promo tape. Morts de Corpus promo tape that you get with an order. You just have to add it to the card. So this is the first one. I haven't checked this out because it's an unboxing, a gay unboxing. But this is quite nice for just a promo tape. So yeah, really nice that this is included. Release to Signal Rex. Signal Rex. So that's the first one. I actually like to tape clear with the red. So that's the first tape. I'm real excited to spin this. Then the second one. Oh yeah, this is a Snorri tape. The weirdest name in Black Metal. This is the tape itself. A lot of sigils. Putrid black fucking metal of death. Snorri. So yeah, this is the tape they did. I think this year. Fuck off, destroy. I don't know what that is, but it's anti-religion. This is a Red J card here. Nicely done. It had a lot of unreadable texts on here. Snorri, yeah, that's the title that Putrid Tape and fucking blah blah blah. So yeah, two great tape releases by SR, which are one is a promo, one is a kind of a full in front of them. And then the tape I was actually gunning for, except from the Black Gangrene update. Once again, extra packed. A lot of bubble. And this is a tape that was gone really quick. I think it's 80 copies or 100 copies, 50 copies, I'm not sure. Limitations, I don't know. This is on Harvest of Death, and this is the Unholy Vampiric Slaughter Sect with the Desecrating the Apostle's Skull. The re-release, I think the original was on Defiled Light. Now it's on Harvest of Death. So yeah, it is a black tape, nothing on there. And yeah, Unholy Vampiric Slaughter Sect was featured heavily already on this channel, so not going to talk too much about it. I'm not sure how this is in relation to black metal, or it's more like the other way that I was talking about, the more noisy stuff. Excuse me, the more beat oriented. This was limited to 66, and I think this is 8 or 18, I'm not sure. So yeah, really glad to have this, because the original is going for way, way much more. This one is already up. I mean, it's pretty, but whatever. Then, there is a zine, the Temple of Adoration, which... No, this was the past, it's alive. Yes. This is the Temple of Adoration, this is issue 12. Yeah, love zines, what can I say? It has a candelabrum article in here, so that's what made me pick it up. But there's a lot more, of course. This is from 2012. Here's the candelabrum off the bat. I love that zine culture is still alive. I mean, kind of fell off in hardcore a bit. There are still some zines, but there are more crossover zines than just plain old black metal or plain old hardcore. Yeah, this looks very interesting. Front and the back, it is stapled. It seems like it was falling apart. That's cool. Then, a 7-inch, I don't think I ordered, so I think this is the extra. Yeah, this is the extra. I was going to order this, but, you know, I was going to order a lot. This is Orida, Icelandic band. I don't know too much about this. I saw it pop up, and I know a lot of people, not a lot of people, but there are some people on Instagram that I really like. For example, Satanist, who has a YouTube channel now, so I'll link it in the description. There's only one video, but he's working on a second one. He had this one, and yeah, I trust his instinct or his taste in music. Recorded in 2016, Reykjavik, Iceland, so that means another Icelandic band for the Signal Rex. Flavio, thank you for the extra 7-inch. It is a white label. There is a etching. That's a weird etching. Master Media. Orida demo. So yeah. Don't know much about it. It is, like I said, an extra that was thrown in here, so artwork is weird. Not sure, is it a building or
Don't know.
I'm going to put these stickers in here. There you go. Then, onto the 12 inches. What is all this? Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. Okay. So, let's start with the first one. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7 inches in here, all from that label. Because they have been killing it lately. This is the first one. This is Endalok. Am I right? Yes, Endalok with, I'm not sure, that's Icelandic. The front cover. And on the back cover there is the title, but Juch Dromheini Vidusht Giblel. Front and back. And this was delayed quite a while. I know a lot of people were bitching about this one. There are a lot of people bitching about records online if you start following. Now, every label is getting shit. Mainly due to limitations they're pressing, but, you know, better to be selling out records than to have a dead stock that's going to sit around for 100 years. So. And the solution is start your own label. Then you can do whatever you want. So yeah, this has been on the back burner for a while. I don't know if there was a problem with production or anything, something like that. I don't know. There is a photocopied lyric sheet in here. And this is one of the two Icelandic bands that he released. And I'm not sure, but can you speak of a, or can you call this the second wave of Icelandic? I'm not sure. Nice quality, very straight record. Just black, nice center labels. Quality on the cardboard, dust check it, not my preferred, but it is quality. So yeah, that's the first one. It's all black metal, of course. And I will provide links for all of these. But it is an unboxing, so it is all new stuff. I'll get out the second Icelandic one, and this is a Drauxsol. Drauxsol, met Voladaland, I think. They all come with these nice little stickers. And this was on my to-get list, not on my want list, but the to-get list, because this is not so, I think they're still available. They are still available, but the limitation escapes me. I'm really not sure. It's really hot in here. Okay. So yeah. And the lock from the back. I love the artwork. It's colorful, but it's dark. With the ringwear circle on there. Really like that one. This doesn't come with anything extra. There's just a black vinyl in here, which has a huge Signal Rex logo. The center labels are, this is a little flimsier. Center labels are quite nice with the big ass Signal Rex logo. Like I said, this is the second of the two Icelandic releases that he did. I'm not sure if they are part of the entire Iceland circle that Mr. Ming is in, and that Nadra is in, and that all those bands that I'm blanking on, Svarti Daudi and Wormlust, and you name them. I'm not sure that these guys are a part of that, but yeah, high praise by a lot of people on these records. So I can't wait to give these a spin. Finally in there. So yeah, that's Drauxsol with Voladaland. That's butchered. 100%. Then, I think the rest is pure Portuguese. Because, of course, Signal X is a Portuguese label. So they have a lot of Portuguese releases. Cheers. Cheers to Mr. Signal X. Cheers to Satan. Satanist for giving me that thing, which is not going to be shown too much, but I think you can make out what that is. That's all I can say. These three releases are Portuguese, all black. First one is something I picked up once again due to the recommendation of Mr. Satanist. It is a collection, not a collection, I shouldn't say that. Let me decipher the name first. Fili Nigratium Infernalium, I think that's the one. A older Portuguese band, if I'm not mistaken. This is not, sorry, this is not on Single Rex. This is a distro item and it's Down with the Most High and Chaos Sphere Recordings split release. And this is a, I mean, I'm not sure if it's a split release because Bacterium is also on here as a band, so it must be a split release. But if it's, maybe it's two bands of the same group of people, I'm not sure. But I picked it up because I saw it on Instagram and it had a tape and blah blah blah, and I just picked up the normal version of the deluxe package with the extra tape and the extra this and the extra that. But it looked interesting enough just to throw it into the order. And like I said, I'm not too familiar, but it has to be two bands because there are two logos on top, two sides. So yeah, this is probably a split release. Very nice pressing, really thick vinyl. Really nice looking center label on this one. And this is, yeah, this is a good vinyl pressing. Nice dust jacket. It comes with two posters. No, it comes with a poster and a booklet. The first is the poster, which is that. Anybody knows anything, and I know a lot of people will, or some people will correct me on this, or just give me some more info, but I think I'm pretty sure that these are two bands, maybe, like I said, of the same band. This is a compilation stuff. It's looking to be a lot of demo stuff, and a other releases, as you can see, with a lot of collage art and a lot of live shots. Another live shot. Some zine interview stuff. So yeah, this is quite a nice release, and I think it's still up on the site, but these copies won't last long, or, I mean, there's not a lot of copies going around of this, but I don't know about the limitation. I feel like I'm rambling today without saying anything. Maybe that's why unboxing is gay. Enough with the gay shit. Two last ones, Crypta Occulta and Ordem Satanica. Two 100% SR releases. Going to flip the record so you can hear the second part. It's good, right? I like it. It's actually made for, in my opinion, it's the ideal soundtrack to drive at night. Good shit. So yeah, first things first. Let's do the let's keep the best for last. This is the Ordem Satanica. This came out around the same time the IRA record came out, but I decided to wait a bit, and like I said, the order was on hold for a while. This is the front, it's called Monte da Lua, Monte de Lua, Monte da Lua, Portuguese, I think. Well, the band's Portuguese, but I don't know if it's the Portuguese language. This is the back, really beautiful production, sturdy cardboard insert with a bad picture and lyrics on the back, a bit out of center here. It comes with a poster. Does it fold open? It folds open. Can I read that shit? Nope. Maybe that's a signature or something like that. Cool little poster. Not really good quality, but nice anyway. And then the record itself comes in a sturdy jacket sleeve with an extra dust jacket, so yeah. Really nice the way these releases are presented. Really weird how the etching is done. It's that won't show up. I'll try to show it. That won't show up, I think. Who knows? It's almost later than mastermedia.net in Germany. Yeah. Straight as a razor. This is a very nice release, and this is some hateful shit. I like the IRAY record very much. That something with humanity and hatred, I think. I can't remember the title, it's over there somewhere. But if this is in the same vein as that stuff, I'm going to enjoy this quite a bit. And then the last one is the Kripta Occulta. I'll show you the front. First, this is in sideways. This is the front cover. Is there a title on this one? No, self-title. And this is, I see it on the spine, it's Signal 32, so it's quite, they don't have too much releases. I mean, we're doing 30, but for a black metal label. It comes with this insert, and I liked, this is what got me into these guys, the picture of them coming through the cavernous stairwell. I like that very much. Is there the insert, or is that the insert? That's the insert. And then the record is just black, like it's all black. Kripta Occulta logo on both sides. Does it have the matrix? Yeah, it's the same matrix. So they're all manufactured at the same point. So yeah, that was the big-ass Signal Rex updates. And check them out, they have a lot of cool stuff. They have a lot of cool stuff in the distro too. Their releases are top notch, and they're really representative of what's going on in Portugal beside the Candelabrum and Black Celeste stuff. So yeah, dig a little deeper, and there are some true gems in there. Yeah, support them, support Harvest of Dead tape label, pick some shit up. Yeah, what can I say? Good guy. He held some stuff for me. This was sold out before the Unholy Vampire Slaughter Sect was sold out, but I guess he still had a copy for me, which is really fucking cool. The only thing that is different from this and the original is this has a previously unreleased Fucking on Altars Still Warm, so this is an extra track on the tape, which makes it very cool in my opinion. The original has like 10 or 8, an addition of 10 or 8, so yeah, really glad to own this one. I missed the last one, the UVSS updates, but can't win them all, right? There is some stuff coming in, so there will be a few new collection updates. There is a massive, I tried to film it this weekend, the Borges discography, but I didn't find the time. It's all there, it's all ready, and then there are a few other videos in the works. So hope you like them, hope you stay, hope you keep following, and hope you keep watching, and hope you enjoy this shit, because yeah, that's what we do it for, I guess. Guys, cheers.